She said, I'm just trying to take it easy, take care of myself. And she said, unless I come to a point where
David,
right, gets really sick. I mean, she's only in her 30s, so, and she's pretty healthy.
But since she had it before.
And she had it before, but she said, I feel worse this time.
Really?
Yeah. So, and you know, I told Brad, I said, she may not have it. It may be a typical
sinus
flu, you know. But two of our friends went to the doctor with sinus infection, and they tested them, and they tested positive for COVID.
Really?
Interesting.
And they both swear they only had a sinus infection, but they still both tested positive.
Mm.
So that's bizarre, you know?
Yeah.
That's kind of
well,
strange.
Well, my dog groomer had some kind of sinus infection, and then she went and got tested, and she said, well, it's not COVID and it's not the flu. They don't know what it is.
Okay.
So
okay.
That
so
is going around, too.
Evidently. And so, you know, I told Diane, maybe you don't have COVID. Maybe you just have. But I said, did he say, don't come near us?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, stay away from everybody for this week.
Yeah.
I would just stay away from everybody for the whole week. Just do your home chores and...
And that's what I told my nephew, who was kind of having those symptoms. He goes, I get tested. I said, no, you live by yourself.
Yes.
Stay home for 5 days.
Exactly. That's,
yeah.
That's why I said, because she stays away from people for 5 days.
Yeah.
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 Unless you get, like, you know, poor David.
Right.
Is very, very sick.
Mm-hmm.
You know, then you have to. But otherwise.
Well, I'm not sure, but I think my dogs might have had COVID.
I think that's a thing.
They say.
Because first the poodle got it, and then it was the barfing and the pooing, and we had that for like 3 days. But one day into it, then the chihuahua starts.
Oh.
And then day three, the poodle's starting to recover, and now the lapso has the same thing. I mean, so it was all the same thing.
Symptoms.
They started with the barfing, and then it was the pooing, and it all resolved within about 3 days. But I thought it was so odd that they all
yeah.
had it.
At the same time?
Could be.
I don't know.
Yeah, it could be.
Yeah.
You just don't
and
know.
And then you wonder where they get it, you know?
Well, you know, they say it can, like, jump because there were gorillas, in the zoo that caught it.
Caught it, yeah.
So I don't know. Maybe at some point I brought it home to them or Jean brought it home.
Yeah.
I don't really know.
You don't know. Yeah,
but it's
you
weird.
Don't. You don't know.
Well, it's like, yeah, like where Diane get it.
Yeah, and that's
no.
what Diane said. Where did I get it from? Yeah,
right.
Because I'm 90% of the time alone.
Yeah.
So, and nobody I know got it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you just, yeah. This, we don't know.
We don't.
I don't know. It's just like the flu.
Yes.
Yeah.
You can walk in the grocery store and get the flu from somebody and you don't even know it.
Yeah.
Right. And anymore, it's everywhere. So.
It's
yeah,
everywhere.
I think it's endemic, it's everywhere.
So, well, thank you for being here. A breath in and out. And another breath in and out. And when you're ready, taking your arms up overhead and leaning to the right side, letting that bottom hand fall away and stretching out. And bringing both hands back to heart center. A breath in and out. Taking our arms up overhead and leaning to the left side. Letting that bottom hand fall away and stretching out. And bringing both hands back to heart center. Another breath in and out. Left hand to the right knee, right hand travels around behind, sitting up nice and tall, overlooking the right shoulder. And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso and seeing if you might be able to look behind you. Coming back to center. Another breath in and out. Right hand to the left knee. Left hand travels around behind, overlooking the left shoulder And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso and seeing if you might be able to look behind you on the other side. And coming back to center. Breath in and out. We'll take our legs wide, stretching out. Right hand to the right ankle, and stretching the left arm over top. Bringing that left hand down to our right toes, right hand to our right toes, and exhaling down, nose to that right knee. And inhaling up, left hand, left ankle, and stretching the right over top. Bringing that right hand down to our left toes, left hand to our left toes, and exhaling down, nose to the left knee. And inhaling up, stretching wide, left fingers, right toes, and exhaling down to that right knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, and exhaling down to our left knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, left fingers, right toes, and again exhaling down. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, and exhaling down to that left knee. And inhaling up, we'll bring both legs together. Here's our forward fold. Inhaling up, bending the right knee, putting that right ankle on top of the left thigh, and stretching forward for our left toes. Taking both legs long, forward fold. Inhaling up, bending the left knee, putting that left ankle on top of the right thigh, and reaching forward for our right toes. And taking both legs long again, forward fold. Into our table position, hands and knees. Starting in our cow position with our head up and relaxing our back. Here's cat, inhaling, tucking my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. And exhaling back around into our cow. And the cat again, inhaling, tucking my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. And exhaling back around into our cow. One more cat, inhaling, tucking my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. And exhaling back around, our path. A breath in and out. We'll do our pigeon. So let's put that right ankle in front of the left knee, pushing the left leg back, drawing up from the torso, and taking both arms up overhead. We'll bring that left hand behind the left thigh. Taking both arms up overhead. And we're going to exhale our hands down to our hips. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhaling down. And once more, inhaling up. We'll bring both hands down in front of that right knee. And then we'll exhale down onto our forearms. And exhaling one more time, dropping our forehead onto the mat and stretching those arms out long in front of us. And unwinding, coming back into our table position. A breath in and out. We'll bring that left ankle in front of the right knee, pushing the right leg back, drawing up from the torso, and taking both arms up overhead. Bringing that right hand back behind the right thigh. Taking both arms up overhead. Exhaling our arms down by our hips. Inhaling up. Exhaling down. Inhaling up. And once more, exhaling down. And inhaling up. We'll bring both hands down beside that left knee. Exhaling down onto our forearms. And exhaling one more time, dropping our forehead onto the mat and stretching those arms out long in front of us. And coming back into our table position. A breath in and out. Let's take that left leg out to the side. We're going to leave the right palm down, rotate, take the left arm fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. And bringing that right hand down, take that left leg back in into our table. A breath in and out. We'll take that right leg out to the side, leaving the right palm down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bring that left hand down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that right hand down, and we're coming back into our table. A nice breath in and out. We'll take that right arm, extend it all the way out in front, and bring that left leg out behind us. Bending my left knee, drawing that right elbow back, connecting left knee. And stretching out, bending my left knee, drawing that right elbow back, connecting left knee, our table. Good breath in and out. We'll take that left arm all the way out in front and that right leg out behind us. Bending the right knee, drawing my left elbow back, connecting, right knee, stretching out, bending my right knee, drawing the left elbow back, connecting, right knee, and stretching out. This time as you bend the right knee, we'll bring that left hand around to see if we can hang on to the right toes. And coming back into our table. That breath in and out. When you're ready, tucking your toes for your down dog. Start by walking the dog. Right knee forward and back, left knee forward and back, just like we're walking. Coming back into our down dog. Take the right hand over to the left ankle. Coming back into our down dog. Taking that left hand over to the right ankle. Coming back into our down dog. And we'll bring the right foot forward in between both hands in front. And when you're ready, inhaling up for your warrior one. Connecting my palms together, extending forward over the right thigh. Bringing that right hand back by our hip. Pushing the left arm forward. Bringing both arms forward. And back up. Warrior one. And we'll take both hands down on either side of the right foot. Scooting that right foot back into our down dog. The left foot forward in between both hands in front. And when you're ready, inhaling up for your warrior one. Connecting my palms together, extending forward over the left thigh. Bringing that left hand back by my hip. Pushing the right arm forward. Bringing both arms forward. And back up for our warrior one. And we'll bring both hands down on either side of the left foot. And we're going to scoot that left foot back into our down dog. And then we're slowly going to roll up and come into our mountain position. A breath in and out. So we're going to leave this right foot on the mat. And we're going to cross the left leg behind the right, so we're kind of doing a curtsy, bending our knees, and holding. And coming up. raise your mountain. Same thing, other side. So we're gonna take that right leg behind the left, just like we're doing a curtsy, bending our knees, and bringing those hands to heart center. Coming back up into a breath in and out. Bringing our hands to heart center. Here we go. We're going to curtsy, bringing that left foot behind the right, bending our knees. And as we hold, let's take both arms up overhead. Stepping back into our mountain. We're going to curtsy the other direction again. Right leg behind the left, bending our knees, hands to heart center. And then taking both arms up overhead and holding. And coming back into our mountain. A breath in and out. Last round, here we go. So we're going to curtsy, bringing the left leg behind the right, bending our knees, bringing our hands to heart center. And let's take this into warrior two arms. So we're going to take that right arm out front, the left behind. Taking the right arm up. Coming back, warrior two arms. And then we're going to take that right hand all the way down. The left is up. And coming back into our curtsy with our warrior two arms. Stepping back into our mountain. A breath in and out. Getting ready, we'll curtsy the other direction, right leg behind the left, bending our knees, bringing our hands to heart center, and warrior two arms. So we'll take that left arm forward, the right is behind. Taking that left arm up. Coming back, warrior two. And then we'll take that left hand all the way down. The right is up. And coming back into our curtsy with our warrior two arms. And returning to our mountain. Breath in and out. We're going to come back into our down dog. Let's cross the right hand over to the left ankle. Coming back into our down dog. We'll take the left hand over to the right ankle. And coming back into our down dog. Let's put our weight on the right foot as we take that left leg out behind us for three-legged dog. Bending my left knee, turning my hip outward, dropping my foot over my hip. And if you need it to be harder, walking your hands back and see if you can put them around the right ankle. And coming back into our down dog. right knee, turning my hip outward, dropping that foot over my hip. And if you want it to be harder, walking your hands back and see if you can put them around the left ankle. And coming back into our down dog. Let's drop down onto our forearms, which puts us in dolphin. Pushing up into our down dog. Dropping down onto our forearms for dolphin. Pushing up into our down dog. And once more, dropping down onto our forearms for our dolphin. And pushing up for our down dog. We'll walk our feet forward, right behind our hands. Slowly rolling upward, reaching on up, and settling into that mountain position. Our breath in and out. Let's do our triangle. Right foot is forward, left is behind. Arms are out. We're going to bring the right hand to the right ankle, and the left arm is up. Maybe taking the right arm and pointing it out to the left side. And we'll bring both hands around the right ankle, looking up for our gazing pose. Making our way back up, stretching our arms out, left fingers, right ankle, and the right arm is up. Maybe taking that left arm and pointing it out to the right side. Putting both hands around the right ankle, looking up for our gazing pose, and making our way back up, settling into our mountain. A breath in and out. Here's our triangle, other side. Left foot is forward, right is behind, arms are up, left fingers, left ankle, and the right arm is up. Maybe taking that left arm and pointing it out to the right side. And then bringing both hands around that left ankle, looking up for our gazing pose, and making our way back up, stretching our arms out. Right hand, left ankle, and the left arm is up. Maybe taking the right arm and pointing it out to the left side. And then bringing both hands around that left ankle, looking up for our gazing pose. And making our way back up, settling into our mountain. Our breath in and out. Getting ready, here's our sun salutation. Arms overhead. Coming forward into our forward fold. hands behind our calves, relaxing our head, relaxing our neck. Putting our hands on the mat in front of our toes, bringing those hands up to our knees, down to the mat, up to our knees, down to the mat, and once more, up to our knees, and back down to the mat. We'll leave the right foot forward, take the left behind into our lunge. Right palm is down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that right hand down, we're coming up in our side angle. Right forearm on top of the right thigh, taking the left arm up overhead. Only thing we'll change is position of our arms, left forearm on top of the right thigh, and taking that right arm up overhead. And then taking that into our reverse warrior. Right hands is a look of the sun. Bringing both hands together, heart center. Connecting my thumbs between my eyebrows, looking up. Bringing those hands to heart center. And our twist, left elbow, right knee, turning to the side. And we'll put both hands down by the right foot. Getting ready, bringing that right foot back into our down dog. Tucking my chin, bringing that left knee forward and holding. Putting the left foot down. Tucking my chin, bringing that right knee forward and holding. Putting the right foot down. And then we're going to settle into our chair position. So bending our knees, taking our arms out front, just like we're sitting in a chair. Keeping your chair position, now just make your stance a little wider, taking your feet to the outside of your mat. Coming back into our regular chair. And heading back into our down dog. And then walking our feet back into our plank position. Here's our hip dip right, right hip towards the mat. Coming back into our plank. Hip dip left, left hip towards the mat. Coming back into our plank. And we're dropping that right knee down to the back. Rolling forward, stretching our left toes. And maybe picking up that left leg and holding. We're going to reach back with the left hand, see if we can find that left toe or our ankle. And then we'll extend that left leg back out again. And come back. dropping our left knee down to the mat, rolling forward, stretching our right toes. And then maybe picking up that right leg and holding. And we're going to reach back with the right hand. See if we might be able to find our right ankle or our toes. Putting that right leg back down behind us. Taking the left leg back into our plank. And coming all the way down. Your choice. Either resting on your forearms for Sphinx, or palms down, and pushing back for Cobra. When you're ready, tucking your toes, down dog. Tucking my chin, bringing that left knee forward and holding. Putting the left foot down. Tucking my chin, bringing that right knee forward and holding. Putting the right foot down. And then we're going to take this into our chair, bending our knees, bringing our arms out front, just like we're sitting in a chair. And we're going to widen our chair stance. Coming back, regular chair. And then returning down dog. We'll bring the left foot forward, the right is behind, into our lunge. Left palm is down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that right hand down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down. We'll come up for our side angle. Left forearm on top of the left thigh, and taking the right arm up overhead. Only thing we'll change is position of our arms. Right forearm on the left thigh, and taking that left arm up overhead. And then taking that to our reverse warrior. Left hand says hello to the sun. Bringing both hands together, heart center. Connecting my thumbs between my eyebrows, looking up. Bringing those hands to heart center. And our twist, right elbow, left knee, turning to the side. And we'll put both hands down by that left foot. And we're getting ready, bringing that right foot forward into our forward fold. Slowly rolling upward, reaching on up, and settling into our mountain position. A breath in and out. Then we'll come forward in our tabletop position. And from table, we're headed over onto our backs. Feet down, knees up, arms wide. A breath in and out. We'll cross that right leg over the left. And we're going to take both knees off to the left side. Mm-hmm. shrimp pose, taking that top leg, extending it long, with the right hand reaching around for the toes or the ankle on the bottom. And then taking that left arm up towards the ceiling. And unwinding. Feet down, knees up, arms wide. Another breath in and out. Let's cross that left leg over the right. And we're going to take both knees off to the right side. If you want to do shrimp pose, taking that top leg, extending it long. With the left hand reaching around for the toes or the ankle on the bottom. And maybe that right arm comes up towards the ceiling. And unwinding, feet down, knees up, breath in, and out. We'll take that right leg all the way up towards the ceiling and roll that right ankle, first one way, and then the other. Pulling my toes towards me, pushing them away, towards me, and away. And then starting that circle with my right leg. Making that circle go around the other way. Taking that right leg all the way up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, lowering that right heel halfway between the ceiling and the floor, and holding. As you exhale, dropping that right heel almost to the mat, not quite there, letting it hover. And then we'll take the right leg all the way up, and with both hands, we're reaching for those right toes. And then releasing out, feet down, knees up. We'll take that left leg up towards the ceiling. And rolling that left ankle, first one way, and then the other. Pulling my toes towards me, pushing them away, towards me, and away, and then starting that circle with my left leg. Making my circle go around the other way. Taking that leg up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, lowering that left heel halfway between the ceiling and the floor. And holding. As you exhale next time, dropping that left heel almost to the mat, not quite there, letting it hover. We'll bring the left leg all the way up, and with both hands, we're reaching for those left toes. And then releasing out, feet down, knees up, a breath in, and out. We're going to take both legs up towards the ceiling. And then we're going to lower both heels down so they hover just off the mat. And as our legs hover just off the mat, we're going to make some very small circles with our leg. So not those giant wide ones, just really small circles, hovering close to the mat. And then making your circles go around the other way. Small circles, close to the mat. Allowing those ankles to hover again. And we'll take our legs all the way back up towards the ceiling. our heels so they hover just off the mat. And then both legs are going to make those really little circles very close to the mat, making the circle go around the other way. Letting those ankles hover just off the mat. And then bringing your legs back up towards the ceiling. Breath in and out. And we'll do one more. So we're going to lower those heels so they hover just off the mat. And then make some little circles, both legs together just off the mat. Making those circles go around the other way. Letting those ankles hover just off the mat. And then bringing our legs back up towards the ceiling. And returning back to our neutral. Feet down, knees up. A breath in and out. We're going to extend our arms and our fingers out towards our knees. And we'll just do that little bit of a curl, picking up our torso, picking up our head, and holding. And relaxing our torso down. Extending our arms and our fingers out towards our knees. And again, picking up our torso, picking up our head, holding that little bit of a curl, and relaxing down. And last one, extending our arms and our fingers out towards our knees, picking up our torso, picking up our head, and holding. And relaxing our torso down. We'll roll over and take a moment in child's pose. And then making ourselves comfortable for our shavasana on our backs. Sponge pose. And we'll begin with those deep breaths in and out. Inhaling all the way in and pushing the air all the way out. Extend our inhalation for about 5 seconds and then push the air out for about 5 seconds. Beginning to notice that place, that pause between our inhalation and our exhalation. Slowly bringing our awareness to our forehead, smoothing out our forehead. Relaxing our eyebrows, relaxing that place between our eyebrows, drawing the relaxation down through your cheeks and into your jaw. Maybe opening your mouth just a little bit as you invite your jaw to relax Bring that relaxation down through your neck. And as you exhale, dropping your shoulders, releasing them. Thinking about deepening that place between the bottom of our ears and the tops of our shoulders. Drawing the relaxation down through our arms, into our wrists, softening our hands, releasing our fingers. Letting our thoughts come and go, not dwelling on any one thing. Bringing that relaxation down through our chest, into our tummy, relaxing our hips, softening our thighs, releasing our knees, lower legs, ankles, and our feet. Continuing to drift and melt. Journey, you find yourself standing beside an open window. As you feel the breeze brush against your skin, you can hear some wind chimes gently chime outside the window. Inhaling the cool, moist air that precedes a summer rain shower through the window, exhaling any remaining tension in your body. Hearing the birds twittering and cooing as some rain clouds gather on the horizon. Noticing the rain shower coming in. You notice now that a little bit of rain begins to fall, one drop and then another, here and there. Noticing the drops as they fall on the leaves of the tree and into the ground. Holding your hands outside the window, feeling the cool raindrops against the palm of your hand. It rains a little harder now, and so you duck back inside the window. And just as suddenly as the rain came on, it's beginning to subside. The sky is getting lighter, and a few birds have bravely ventured out. And as more and more birds venture out after the rain shower, you notice the sound of the birds seems louder and louder. Feeling the coolness, feeling refreshed in the air that's clean after the rain showers. Noticing the sun beginning to shine from behind the few of the clouds that are left. The rays begin to warm the drooping flowers and plants, taking a moment and just seeing what's meant for you to see as you gaze outside the window. to your breath, noticing its peaceful, easy rhythm. Taking a moment to give thanks for whatever comes to mind today. Also, taking a moment to think about our intentions, all those good things we'd like to do, gathering those positive affirmations in our mind. And when we have those intentions gathered together, either in our mind's eye, or we can raise our arms up over our head and send all those good thoughts outward. Beginning to reconnect with our bodies, noticing the rise and fall of our chest as we inhale and as we exhale. Checking in with our fingers, wiggling our fingers, seeing how they feel. Checking in with our toes, wiggling our toes, noticing how they feel. Allowing our senses to bring us back to the room around us. Any sounds in the room, the temperature of the room. Taking a deep breath in, exhaling out. And when you're ready to come back from your journey, only when you're ready to come back, gently sitting up and taking your time.